Hey, bro. Hear my intro.
What's happening, my visionaries?
It's your man, J Rock.
Back in effect. I'm live and direct, and I'm coming at your neck with yet another. Video, baby.
Ah. The video, man, as always, just like, subscribe if you want to. If you don't, then just do it if you want to do it, because Jesus said this is the right thing to do.
What's happening, my visionaries? Man, J Raw, man. Back up in the stand. Yes, indeed, another video, man.
Appreciate you for coming once again. So, as you can see from the title, if you do have the ability to see, if not, then you can listen to my voice, you know, auditory and ear. So, if it isn't either one of those things, then you see the title of the video. I'm about to react to Evanescence, My Immortal. Now, I've never heard of this song before, but I am. But the extent of my familiarity with Evanescence, it is, of course, Wake Me Up, which is a song that just about everyone is familiar with to a degree, rather that you are familiar with it because you're aware of it, cognizant that you're familiar with it, whether that you have this sort of unknown familiarity with it, that you've heard it, but you're not keenly cognizant or aware of its existence. But you, when you hear it, it's one of those songs that when you hear, you know. So, and also just inferring from the thumbnail of the video, this black and white sort of what I believe perceived to be iconography or visualizations, sort of just gives me the inference that this is going to be a song that's going to be melancholic, it's going to be a little bit foreboding. And the lead singer, which I believe her name is Amy Lee, if I'm not mistaken, she has this siren quality as it pertains to her, you know, voice modulation, and the way that she sings, her inflections is just amazing. But I digress. Let me put on my headphones the truth. Bam, we gonna do what it do. Evanescence, My Immortal. Let's do it. Oh, yep. Melancholic piano chords.
I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you would just leave. Your presence still lingers here, and it won't leave me alone.
These like those strings
won't seem to heal. This pain too real. There's just too much that time cannot erase. When you cried, I'd wipe away all of your tears. When you scream, I'd fight away all of your fears. And I held your hand for all of these years, but you still.
Loving the resonancy of these piano chords as well. And the strings. Great tone, great tonality.
You used to captivate me by your resonating light. Now I'm bound by the life you left behind. Your face it haunts my once pleasant.
Love the background vocalizations, those harmonies.
And I held your hand through all
love this chord progression on the chorus.
Still.
specifically, obviously, with the piano and the strings. Like this bridge. That was a very seamless transition. Yeah, I'm really, really, really enjoying this rhythm section. Like the saturation of the guitar contrast. Love the harmonies. Double vocals, nice stereo. Yeah. So that was My Immortal by, you know, the fuck. So that was My Immortal by Evanescence. It's I believe that my initial inference and sort of hypothesis was correct, but that's not a negative thing. It's exactly what I thought it was going to be, but just because that's what I expected doesn't diminish its sort of the impression that it has upon me. And it's that it's not, you know, it's obviously emotive, that. And somewhat in the instrumentation and the instrumentation as well as the vocal palettes, it's very almost what I could describe as being rock orchestra, if that's a genre correlation or genre term that I would correlate it to. It does have this sort of musical score orchestral sort of twang to it. Interspersed with obviously those more those rock elements towards the end, especially. So that's where the correlation comes in as well. It was much more of a straightforward and direct song than I initially thought it was going to be. Which again, there's not anything wrong with that necessarily. I don't think that it at all diminishes nor depreciates the sort of, the sort of evocation of emotionality that it can, you know, incur from listening to this song. And just, you know, just listening to some of the lyrics, I can honestly tell what this is about. Just to a sort of brief synopsis or some summation of this. For me, when I heard initially, it could be pertaining to sort of their relational component of you being so intertwined with an individual that once that individual is no longer there, a piece of themselves become immortalized with your being. You sort of no longer have this prevalence of individualism, though it is now that this it's essentially a stain that cannot be removed. and perhaps not quite as caustic or not quite as contemptuous as that interpretation could be, but more that that loss, that pain that's exerted when you are dealing with losing someone, or that you deeply care for. So just that being immortalized with that, from that individual being immortalized within you, within your memory and all those other components of the self. So sort of an existential, in a manner of speaking, from a sort of pseudo philosophical standpoint. But yeah, so you know, this ballad is definitely, I suppose, just depends. Is all, and music is all in subjective, and subjectivism is an interpretive. Could be, you know, very harrowing, haunting, especially with the musicality and the composition of this, which I do enjoy. I enjoy the rhythm section, this, especially that towards the end when that transition to the, like I said, like I previously aforementioned, the more rock elements of the song. But yeah, just looking at the verses, I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you would just leave, because your presence still lingers here and it won't leave me alone. At times, whether it be pertaining to a relationship, an amorous relationship that you have with another individual, or a familial relational aspect of it, when someone is no longer there, whether they are deceased or whether they just simply are no longer a part of your life, you know, she's stating that she has these repressed emotions and this repressed psychological agony of that she, what, how she describes it or classifies it as childish fear. So these infantile fears and infantile, what she believes is infantile, and sort of the manner of approaching these fears. So she says, I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you could just leave, because your presence still lingers here and it won't leave me alone. Sometimes those things can sort of be analogous to an apparition, a ghost of sorts. Not a physical manifestation, but rather the mental and emotional manifestation of all the agonizing pain that's, you know, conflated with the loss of someone. Then the pre-chorus is, these wounds won't seem to heal. This pain is just too real. There's just too much time that cannot erase. And this is a great example of simplistic songwriting that doesn't have to be convoluted or complex to get his point across. Because I believe that sometimes a lot of things can be very superfluous and be very unnecessary in order to write an effectual song. I think to write a song is not pertaining to nor related to any form of being convoluted just for the sake of being convoluted, being sort of a sesquipedalian, or being, you know, utterly loquacious just for the sake of being so, just for the sake of, you know, verbose, really is what it is. I think you can really be very simplistic in songwriting and still convey a point that you want to convey, and I think this does a great job of that. These wounds just won't seem to heal. The pain is just too real. There's too much time that time cannot erase. Simply just stating that, you know, that adage and that aphorism of time heals all may not be applicable to this, and time may heal. But to me, when I hear that aphorism, for me, it more refers to the time does heal, but it's also what you do within that particular time parameter that can allow the healing, because healing can only occur when you acknowledge that healing needs to transpire. So, when you cried, I wiped away all of your tears. When you scream, I fight away all of your fears. So could be referring to someone that she, the individual that maybe she lost, or this individual lost, and just stating that those times of peril, those times of you know, dejection, that this individual was there to wipe away the tears, to be of console, of consolation to this other individual. And this that entire chorus is just, to me, really the just encompasses that notion of consolation, of being consoling. And I held your hand through all of these years, but you still have all of me. So essentially stating that I've done all these things while we were together, while we were in this enshrined in this moment. But now that moment has enshrined itself with me, and the part of you is immortalized within me, and it simply will not leave me. Verse 2, you used to captivate me by your resonating light. Now I'm bound by the life. I like that external rhyme scheme with light and life, just depending on how you, phonetically, how you express it. So I like that linguistic thing, light, life. It don't really rhyme, but you can make it rhyme, trust me. Now I'm bound by the life you left behind. Your face, it haunts my once pleasant dreams. Your voice, it chased away all the sanity in me. Yeah, just more of a continuation from the previous, from the chorus and the previous verse. Simply saying that this, whatever their relational aspect was, it used to be captivating, it used to be invigorating, enthralling, but now it is now precipitated to, and by a resonating light. So this person used to be emanating light that used to be just radiate this positivity, radiate this alacrity, this vivacity, but now it states that I'm bound by the life that you left behind. So again, could be referring to that this person is no longer present physically on this earth. So your face, it haunts once my pleasant dreams. Your voice it chased away all the sanity in me. So still being haunted by the memories of another individual, repressing those emotions into the psyche, then my once pleasant dreams, so the once pleasant reveries I once had are now mired by no more than, by nightmares, or rather the redundancy of being haunted by these repressed memories that they shared. Your voice had chased away all the sanity in me. So essentially just stating that merely hearing this individual's voice just removes all sanctity within this person. And it goes back to the pre-chorus of the wounds won't seem to heal. The pain is just too real. There's just too much the time cannot erase. When you cried, I wiped away all your tears. When you scream, I fight away all your fears. And when I held your hand through all these years, but you still have all of me. Yeah, so essentially, I believe my initial interpretation of it is that it's could be about the loss of a relative or significant other, or that relational aspect from the lost relative or lost significant other. They all conflate, and they all can be applicable and apropos to any situation that you may interpret it as. And that's the beauty of music, it's interpretive. So let me know what you think down in the comment section below. And this has been quite the extensive video. I didn't expect it to last this long. But I'm done talking, man. I suppose there's nothing else to say, but visionaries, I salute you. Remember, I say best, never stress. I always do your very best. Live, love, love life. Because why? Because life is beautiful. That's why. I'm going to catch y'all on the flip side, baby. I'm out. Deuces. Mwah. Let's see if me and you can maintain. I just wanna know.